Thomas Kissinger coming to you here in Breckenridge, Colorado. It's about 15 degrees this morning. Super cold today, a lot of snow on the ground. We're going to do some activities later today, just enjoying ourselves here with the family. This is going to be If God Could Save Everyone, Would He? Part 2 in the series. And we've been reading from the pamphlet of Dr. Stephen Jones. And here's what we need to consider when we bring this question to light. Is God able to save all people? Is God willing to save all people? Because if all will not be saved in the end through the Lord Jesus Christ, that is an indictment against either God's power or God's love, meaning that God does not have enough power to do it, or He doesn't have the love or the care to do it. But come to find out when we read the scriptures and study to show ourselves approved that this message of the ultimate restoration of all things is in the scriptures, that Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world, that God is going to save everyone and reconcile all things unto Himself. So let's pick up here, get into this a little bit more. The Bible does not teach that God is a loser. The Bible tells us clearly that God will be the ultimate winner and that His plan for all of creation will be fulfilled. God's intent and plan was clearly stated in a vow to Moses, saying in Numbers 14:21, "As I live, all the earth will be filled with the glory of the Lord." 2 Peter 3:9 says that He is not willing that any should be lost or perish. Thus, if any are lost, it is not because it is the will of God. The Apostle Paul says in 1 Timothy 2:4 that God will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. This too defines the will of God for all men. The problem is that evil men seem to thwart God's will, and God seems to be powerless to do anything about it. How powerful is God anyway? Let us begin at the beginning. The Creator owns all things. We got to realize this, ladies and gentlemen. God is the Creator, and God owns what He creates. It's His property. The first verse in the Bible establishes that God is the Creator of all things. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Most people in the world believe this, but few people understand what this actually implies. It means that God owns all things by right of creation. One owns what one creates. You got it? This is why God told Moses in Leviticus 25:23, "The land shall not be sold in perpetuity, for the land is mine." In other words, under Bible law, God holds the right of eminent domain. He has divided the land of Canaan among the tribes and families of Israel as their inheritance. However, they did not have the right to do as they pleased with their land. God retained sovereignty over the land. The people's rights were limited by certain restrictions set down by the law. This shows that God retained sovereignty over the land even though He gave the people a certain level of authority. One restriction was that they did not have the right to sell their property forever, that is, in perpetuity. Their inheritance was non-transferable. If they incurred a debt, they were allowed to sell it only until the year of Jubilee, which occurred every 49 years, Leviticus 25:8. This meant that a family could not lose their inheritance for more than a generation. It ensured that every citizen would have land. The land belonged to God, so no man had the ability or the right to lose his land for all of time. He was only capable by his own will to lose it temporarily, because that was the extent of his authority. By law, under God's sovereignty, a man could only lose or sell his land temporarily. Now consider the fact that God created all men, both good and bad. In fact, He formed man of the dust of the ground. God used building material, dust of the ground, that He created and therefore owned. This means that God owns all men. Did you get that? This means that God owns all men. You are not your own. You are bought with a price and paid for by the Lord Jesus Christ. So not only did God create you and he owns you, but then you were bought back by the Lord Jesus Christ and by the blood of his cross, because we were sold into sin and then we were bought back. So God owns all men as well as all material things in the universe. Man is part of the land that God owns by right of creation. That means man does not have the authority, right, or even the ability to sell his soul to the devil for all time. His authority is limited by law. Hence, even if a man decides by his own free will to sell himself into bondage to sin or to the devil, he must inevitably return to his inheritance at the end of time when God decrees the jubilee for all creation. So here's what we're saying, ladies and gentlemen. God created all things, and we know that in Adam all die, and that because of that, man is mortal and man sins. But Jesus Christ came to redeem mankind back. He purchased everyone back. Remember, you are not your own, but you are bought with a price. The Son of Man came to seek and save that which was lost, which was the human race. We are not able to sell ourselves to sin and to the devil forever and ever. That's the good news of the gospel. But I would tell you to come to the Lord today. This is not telling you, hey, wait to come to the Lord later down the line. But the thing is that God has a plan to save all mankind, because he's the creator and he's the redeemer. And there's going to be a great creation's jubilee. So we'll stop there for this time, and we're going to pick it up next time where we left off.